In this episode of Byte Size, I'm looking at the original Pentium processors and why there was a 60 MHz and a 66 MHz variant. The original Pentium branded CPUs were expected to be named 586 or I586 to follow the naming convention of previous generations. However, as the company wanted to prevent their competitors from branding their processors with similar names, Intel attempted to file a trademark on the name in the United States, only to be denied because a series of numbers was not considered distinct. Following Intel's previous series of the 8086, 186, 286, 386, and 486 processors, the company's first P5-based microprocessor was released as the original Intel Pentium on March 22, 1993. Marketing firm Lexicon Branding was hired to coin a name for the new processor. The suffix "-ium" was chosen as it could connote a fundamental ingredient of a computer, like a chemical element, while the prefix "-pent" could refer to the 5th generation of x86. Now, the first Pentium processors available were 60 and 66 MHz, but why, may you ask, did Intel design a processor with only 6 MHz difference in speed? Well, here's why. The Pentium was a really tough chip to design. Every Intel chip design team is extremely limited in that no matter what the new chip's able to do, the one thing that it must do is run old software. This demand for backward compatibility makes for complex chips, and complex means a lot of little components go into one chip, or as insiders would say, the backward compatibility needs a lot of silicon. Now, all that silicon generates heat. Put too much silicon into a small place and it starts to damage itself. Make the clock run faster and the silicon gets even hotter. The Intel folks were just plain running up against some physical design barriers. The Pentium showed its heat requirements in technical specifications. According to Intel, the 60 and 66 MHz Pentium should be expected to generate heat enough to bring the chip to 85 degrees centigrade, and that's about 185 degrees Fahrenheit. Intel tried its hardest to make a 66 MHz Pentium chip work, but it was just so difficult that they ended up making Pentium chips that were mostly rejects. They weren't rejects, however, if they ran at a somewhat slower, cooler rate, like 60 MHz. So the 60 MHz chips are unfortunately just the rejects. Intel just lowered the standards to make them sellable. And that, my friend, is how chip design and marketing works in a capitalist world.